Hola Javier, ¿cómo estás? Camilo Alfaro y aquí estamos en Amelia Island para el Concurso de Elegance y estamos con nuestro gran amigo Tomás Prusinski, gerente general de comunicaciones para BMW. Tomás, how are you today?
I'm very good, thank you. And you?
Very good, thank you. It is just a glorious day here at Amelia once again.
It really is. We've been very lucky these past few years. The days leading up to Amelia Island are not always perfect, but when we get to show day, it's always just right on. I don't know how they do it, but they do it every year for us.
I have no idea how they do it. I'm not sure what Bill does, the founder of the show, to make this day so beautiful, but there are thousands and thousands of people browsing an unbelievable collection of cars, and I could see the crowds gathering around these beautiful BMW race cars you have here.
Exactly, yes. So this is the 40th anniversary of BMW North America, so that means the first year that BMW was officially imported into the U.S. by the factory. Prior to that, it was imported by an importer. And so in 1975, we bought out the importer and began distributing BMWs in the U.S. So this is our 40th anniversary this March, actually today, in fact, March 15th, 1975. So that's the first anniversary we're celebrating. The second is it's the 40th anniversary of the ultimate driving machine tagline. We're really the only manufacturer that has kept the tagline for that length of time, and it really has meant that it defines who we are. It's really part of our culture now, this ultimate driving machine. And then the third anniversary, is the anniversary of our first motorsport win at the 12 Hours of Sebring in 1975. So with us we have the 3.0 CSL that won that race with Brian Redman and crew. And then to celebrate that, next weekend at the 12 Hours of Sebring, we will race with a new car, a Z4 GTLM, with a livery that pays homage to that first car back in 1975.
So we should definitely be raising a glass of champagne today for this amazing, I mean, yeah, four anniversaries. I mean, that's unbelievable.
Yeah, well, let's celebrate three of them for now, all right, with a glass of champagne. And then after Sebring next weekend, hopefully we can raise another glass of champagne for a good finish there.
Absolutely. Now, I see a lot of people gathering around a stunning collection of 328s that you have here.
Yes, exactly. Bill Warner, the chairman of the Concours, is honoring Sir Stirling Moss this year, and we have a 328 that Sir Stirling Moss won his first professional victory in. So that's a very important car. And then we have a range of eight 328s that are very special from cars that race at Mille Miglia, and they're one-off cars, so there's only one of each of these. So there's a car with, they call it the Creased Fender Mille Miglia Roadster. It has nice little creases across its very aerodynamically shaped fenders. And then at the other end of the range here, we have this Mille Miglia Touring Coupe, which is a very lightweight construction, all aluminum, and it was an aerodynamic study for Mille Miglia, and it did very well back in its day. So that's from the late 30s, early 40s.
But that is just a beautiful car. I mean, it looks like it could get very hot inside of it.
It might be, yes. But Italy, I guess at the time of year when they run the Mille Miglia, is not so hot. So I guess it worked out fine in those days. It doesn't have air conditioning, so I guess it'd be quite hot on a day like today in Florida.
No, but I mean, it's a very aerodynamically vehicle.
Absolutely.
And back in the day, I mean, it must have been very difficult to have those type of studies. I mean, they must have been very genius to do something.
It was, and that made the cars very successful in racing back in the day. You can see the rear fenders are flared in, and everything was flared in order to make it as smooth as possible. Even the turn signals, they slide into the C pillar behind the windows there, and you can hardly see them when they're not being used, but they flip out when they're needed. So all kinds of little details like that make the car really special. And again, it's a one-off. There's one of them.
It's unbelievable. I mean, these are vehicles that had to be made by hand. So,
exactly.
I mean, the craftsmanship behind them must have been very impressive.
Exactly. And they were done by, Touring Coupe was done by Carrozzeria Touring out of Italy. And the other one was done in-house. The Mille Miglia Roadster was done in-house. But it is a very special-looking car and a very successful race car in its day.
Well, thank you, Tomás, for taking the time here to be on the show with us. And I really appreciate it. Good luck to you at Sebring next week.
Thanks, Camilo.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.